What was the source of inspiration for the film? Where the idea for this movie come from?
3つ短編があると思うんですけども、納豆とその、ね、3つあると思うんですけど、で納豆はこう日本の独自 の食材でこう非常にこう変わった食材というか、すごく臭くて、でこうネバーっとこうしていってっていうその変な食材なんですけども、その納豆の存在自体が、まあ、エロチックだなと思っていて、それをまず最初にこう作ろうと思ったのが一番、まあ、最初のインスピレーションですかね。まずそこの方で、
はい、actually that, of course you know that, I mean that there are three stories and but、he just like made the natto first and then he got the inspiration from natto. It's a very Japanese original unique fermented soybean, you know what I mean, the dishbecause it's very like a stinky and like you know what I mean, very also like a sticky and you know what I mean, very, but that's like you know what I mean, those characters like characteristics are very erotic, he thought, so that's why the other he got the, you know what I mean, the kind of basically like inspiration like from the natto food.
I was pretty amazed by the performance in the film. It's very delicacy or nuance in their acting. So I'm wondering how was the process of making the actor ready for the film? Was there any kind of improvisation involved or was it all was predetermined acting?
作品によってちょっとまちまちなんですけど、まず女性がその美しく見えるっていうのはすごく嬉しいなと思って、っていうのは例えば最初納豆にすると、橋本まなみさんはいわば納豆を食べてるだけなんですよ。で、納豆を食べてるだけなんですけど、それがなぜかエロチックで、なぜかものすごく綺麗に映ってほしいと思っていたんですよね。で、それはなんかその納豆のそのから、その人間の本質的な部分が見えてくる、本質的な美しさが見えてくるっていうふうにしたいなと思っていたので、なんかそこでこう大きくどういうふうにその納豆を食べてほしいとかっていう演技のあれは実はあんまり言ってないんですけど、とにかく美味しそうに食べてほしいっていうことがあれでしたかね。まあ橋本さんにしてみたらそうかなって感じです。
はい。どうぞ。大丈夫ですよ。
大丈夫ですか。はい、で麻婆豆腐の佐藤さんにすると、佐藤さんの、アクティングは、彼女のキャラクター自身が非常にその隠れたその欲求というかものを持っているクリエイティブな子だと思ったんですよね、あのキャラクターが、あかねという人物が。なんで最後にその麻婆豆腐を作る、というシーンがあると思うんですけども、あそこでは、まあ、麻婆豆腐を作りながら自分でそのなんかアートをやってるような雰囲気というかっていうような感じで、自分が本当にこう作りたいものを作っていくというこのクリエイティブな欲求を出していくというようなつもりで、麻婆豆腐を作ってくださいっていうふうに言いましたかね。で、最後のラーメンは武田さんは武田さんもね、なんか結構直接的に言ったかな、なんか今どの程度今食べてる状態で男がいなくて寂しいとか、その寂しい男がいないがゆえに、そのなんか思い切ってそのめちゃくちゃにされたい気持ちだったりとかっていうことを考えながら、ラーメン食べてくださいっていうふうに言ったかなと思います。で武田さんは非常にこうなんかドラマで食べる演技をたくさんしているので、すごく上手でしたね。感情、食べながら感情を乗せるのがすごく上手でした。
はい、okay, so he just thank you, like, you know, I mean, that you thought the female character's performances are very beautiful because he intended to, like, you know, I mean, make it like that, first of all. And actually, the first female character in natto, Manami Hashimoto, the actress, so basically, like, you know, I mean, all she does in the film is, like, eating natto. So, he just like, you know what I mean, tried to like shot like all, you know what I mean, the cut and everything, like, you know what I mean, very beautifully and also the erotically. So he tried to like, you know what I mean, make it like that. And because the natto, the basically like, you know what I mean, pretty much like stands for the like even like Natto itself, like you know, I mean, he thinks the other, it's like shows the other very unique the nature of beauty or something, like you know, I mean, the very unique things, like you know, I mean, the so he just like asked the actress, like you know, I mean, just try to like eat natto like very like she likes it and like you know, I mean, very like happy to eat like that. So basically, like you know, I mean, all ask you know, I mean, he asked the other to her, like you know, the basic, you know, I mean, basically like that. And then like the second the part, the mapo tofu, Sato Manami, Sato Honami-san. So she basically like, you know, has a the character of role is like you know, I mean, has the hidden kind of desire, like the character itself, and also the very the creative like desire something, like you know what I mean, he thought he thinks like you know what I mean, that the character is like that. So the basically like he asked the actress, like you know what I mean, to make the mapo tofu. It's very like you know what I mean, the creatively you know, the like desire, like she shows the desire of like creativity of them. So that's like you know what I mean, he asked her. And the third part, the actress Mina Takeda. So actually that she's very like the good at the eating like style, like because like, she already like you know what I mean, the like acted in some TV series or something, so like to eat the food and stuff like that. So she already like know how to like you know what I mean, the eat and act together. And but also like you know what I mean, he asked the director asked the actress like to show the other like kind of loneliness, and but also like you know what I mean, that she wants to like make wanted to buy like very sexually violated or something, like you know what I mean, that those kind of the desire, like you know what I mean, that he asked like her to show that, you know what I mean, the character. But basically like you know what I mean, the actress already like you know what I mean, that has the ability to like you know what I mean, show those kind of things, like you know what I mean, particularly like through the eating, you know what I mean, the style or something.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, that's interesting film in the sense that it's about sexual desire. But we don't have any kind of sexual scenes. It's mostly with talking and food eating. So I wonder if the director can say why the reason that he decided to show toward that film doesn't include any kind of real sexual scene.
あの、直接的なそのセックスのシーンっていうものを例えばこう撮るとあのセックスがありますよね。それはあのセックスなんですよね。セックスしか過ぎないというか。でそれもなんかセックスを見せるっていうことでしかないんですけども、例えばそのセックスにおけるそのエロティックなものを表現したってなった時にはその直接的なじゃない、例えば食べ物だったりとか匂いだったりとかなんかそういう、こう音だったりとかっていう直接的じゃないものの方がお客さんがその一つ一つのエロティックなものに対してイメージ、イマジネイメージは働かすので、そっちの方がその映画を見てる時に自分で考えながら見れるので、よりこう知的好奇心があの刺激されて面白いなと思っていて、まあ、自分もそうなので、あのそこを目指しました。
はい、of course you know that I mean that if the he uses the other explicit sex scenes, then like you know that I mean that basically like the audience get just like the image is like you know that I mean the sex only.But like if he's, you know what I mean, the shows the sexual scenes like through the food or kind of like a scent smell or also like, you know what I mean, the sounds and everything, those kind of the aspects, then the audience like uses their imaginations, like then like, you know what I mean, and they can stimulate their the imagination, like also the like intelligent, you know what I mean, like sense or something. So that's why the other he wants to use the food or smell or like the sounds and or other aspects or something. So yeah.
Mm. It's very ironic that one of the central characters in the film is a kind of limp. He had a kind of a stroke. It's not a kind of body that you usually refer to as a very sexually active. He's physically, he has a physical disfiguration. And it makes it a very interesting contrast. And when you see that he's always thinking or about sex and thinking about masochistic sex. So I'm just curious if you can say more about this character and the idea where it came from and this kind of irony. Was he trying to say something about sex and body?
まあ、クリタは非常にこう一番分かりやすい言葉でいくとホームレスという、 こう役なのかなと思っていて、でホームレスの視点っていうものが僕は一番自分でも大事にしている視点なんですよね。でそれがその、人々の物事を見るときに、上から見るのではなくて下からこう物事を見ていかないと人の本質は見えてこないっていうのではないかなと思っていて、でそういう、 こう価値観をベースにした、キャラクターがクリタに、やってもらいたかったというかっていうことですかね。今質問あってます。これで大丈夫ですか。
あ、はい、大丈夫だと思います。はい、Actually, the character of Kurita, the you know, the shabby guy, so he basically like put the image like to him like as a like homeless people or something.So like, because those kind of people, like, you know what I mean, look at the world and like society and everything, like from the bottom to top. I mean, like, you know what I mean, it's not like the other people who would like look at the other from the top to like, you know what I mean, from the top, you know, like it's a vice, like opposite side. I mean, because then like, you know what I mean, those kind of people can see more like the other nature or like, you know what I mean, the hiddenlike truth or something like, you know what I mean, he thinks. That's why the other, like he uses the character, like, you know what I mean, basically he wants to like, you know what I mean, get the other perspective from the other, like kind of homeless people, I mean like from the bottom to top. So that's like, you know what I mean, he tried to like make it to the character of Kurita.
Mm-hmm. In terms of the food and the images, I wonder if there was any kind of cinematic or literature inspiration for example, for picking this food or picking this type of chocolate, stuff like that. Where the idea for this food and its the relationship with the sex come from?
さっきは納豆は言ったんですけど、その納豆とそのねばっこさんみたいなことがエロチックなところで、でほら納豆は例えばその臭いものだったりとかっていうことは比較的その人間でその嫌じゃないですか。本当はそのなんかこう綺麗なものがすごくいいというかなんですけど、納豆って言えばそのちょっと汚い臭いし、でもなんかそこのその良さみたいなものを描きたいなと思っていて、でセックスも日本でいうとその例えば表ではみんなその綺麗事のように避けて通るんだけども、本当裏ではすごくやっていることというかってことではあるので、そういうこともなんか表現したかったなというふうに思ってますかね。これ正しいですか。
はい、大丈夫だと思います。はい、はい、actually the like for example natto、so it's very like the stinky and like kind ofDirt, like dirty looking, you know what I mean, the thing. So like people try to like, you know what I mean, the kind of ignore those kind of things, like, you know what I mean, in society or something. Like it's like, you know what I mean, just the natto is the example of those kind of things. But of course, those kind of things has very like, you know what I mean, the good things and virtue as well. And then the sex is also like, you know what I mean, basically like, you know what I mean, we try to like, you know what I mean, not to talk about, you know what I mean, the sex or like something like in the surface, you know, in the society. But of course, you know what I mean, everybody like, you know what I mean, do like sex and like, you know what I mean, So it's like kind of like like not try to like, you know what I mean, ignore those like, you know what I mean, the like things, you know, you understand, like, you know what I mean. So like basically, like, you know what I mean, the food and those the food and sex, like, you know what I mean, are similar to, like, you know what I mean, the so that's why that he uses those kind of food and like, and yeah, so, so that's the other idea.
Yeah, in the terms of location and settings, we have three major locations in the film: a house, a car, and a restaurant or bar that returns at the end. So I'm wondering why was the reason that he picked these three locations? Was this a kind of connotation between sex and these places? So I'm wondering if you can say more about the location setting and place.
Hi, ロケーションは比較的あのちょっとなんだろう、テイオさんなりの作り方みたいなのが正直あったりして、あの例えば今回の話でいくと、最初の納豆はもう最初から家のワンロケーションで行こうというふうには思ってたんですよね。で、まあ、それは予算のもちろん兼ね合いもあるんですけども、ただそのワンロケーションにすることによって外であの描かれていることを想像するというその構造にできるといいなと思ったんです。その栗田が話すことはすべてあの病院の話とかはあるんですけど、病院のシーンは一個も出てきませんし、なんでそのすべてこう想像させるというか、その一個のシチュエーションにまとめることによってというような作りを、やりたいなっていうふうに、思ってました。で、セクション次のその車のやつはこれもあのちょっと納豆からの逆算なんですけど、まあ、納豆が比較的その部屋のワンシチュエーションの会話劇、というところはあるので、次はそのアクション映画にしたいなと思ったんですよね、麻婆豆腐って。で、カーアクションにしたいと思っていて、でデスプルーフみたいなの映画にしたいと思ってたんですけど、で、まあ、そんなデスプルーフになってないんですけど、まあ、そういうアクションシーン、カーアクションにしたい、あの激しいそのラーメン麻婆豆腐の作るその、アクションとかけてアクションシーンにしたいから、それはあの車の中の設定にしました。で、最後のラーメンシーンはあの、まあ、これも、まあの次のその麻婆豆腐からの逆算なんですけど、麻婆豆腐がそのアクションでカーアクションだとしたらば、あというかその納豆とその、麻婆豆腐でクリタがずっと出すっぱりで、あのなのでもうお客さんはその時にはもうクリタの存在は十分に分かっているので、麻婆豆腐あのラーメンの時にはもう登場ほとんどさせないで、その彼の声だけでいろんなイマジネーションをこう膨らませていくというような物語にしたいと思ったんですよね。それがまあラーメン店のワンシチュエーションで、でラーメン店がその日本の言うそのなんていうんだろう、ちょっと独特な店内で喋ってはいけないみたいな、そういうこうちょっと面白いあの文化が あるので、それを使ったサスペンスにしたいなと思ってラーメン店を選びましたかね。
はい。So, first episode Natto, so he already like decided like to use the only like one house location from the beginning. Of course, you know what I mean. It's also like the reason. One of the reasons is like, you know what I mean. This is like a very like a low budget film, so the it doesn't cost much. Like, you know what I mean, for shoot, like it's only like one location. But it's also like, you know what I mean, he wanted to the audience to think about like what happened like outside of the house, you know. So it's more like the like he wants to the audience to use the imagination or something, like basically like the this is like very like the conversation drama. So like just talking, like, you know what I mean, the guys are talking like, but like, you know what I mean, he wants to like express like, you know what I mean, other than those, like, you know what I mean. So that's why he just like limited just one location, and then like he like try to like stimulate the audience like for the imagination. So that's the one set location, like, you know, only that's the reason like for the first episode. The second episode, it's basically like, you know what I mean, he already made the natto, and then like wants to like make the different thing. So like actually that he wants to make the car action drama like for the Mabo Dofu. So like do you know the Disprove the film, like Tarantino film or something maybe. So mm-hmm. like, and that's the other, his like first intention. So, so that's why that he used the car setting. So that's the second one. And then the other third one, so like it's also like, you know, I mean, the creator, like, you know, I mean, already appears in the natto and mabo tofu. So like the he doesn't like want creator to show up in the third scene, third episode. So and so that's the basic, you know, I mean, the setting he tried to like, you know, I mean, the set the location, but also like, you know, I mean, the ramen restaurant. So it's very like the like a ritual style, like, you know, I mean, the customers can't speak, you know, I mean, any word or something, like, you know, I mean, just like the focus on the eating ramen, and you know, that's very like a unique and like interesting thing. So that's why the he wants to like, you know, I mean, show those kind of the other kind of ritual cultural like thing, like, you know, I mean, in Japan, I mean, like a ramen culture or something, you know.
Mm-hmm. So you mentioned that it was a kind of low budget film. I wonder how long the whole process of shooting take place, if you can say more about the process of filmmaking and also the funding, how he was able to secure the fund for this indie independent project.
はい。一応撮影日数は全部含めると6日、7日、9日、まあ約10日ぐらいですかね。10日はないか。まあ約10日ぐらいですかね。で、であったんですが、ファンドか。は基本的にうちの会社が、僕が所属している会社が少ないお金を出して、うん、あと一応その日本でクラウドファンディングがあったので、それもやりました、ね。そこでじゃあ半分ぐらい、クラウドファンディングでお金募集してやったって感じがありました、ね。
はい。はい、so in total, like the shooting days are like maybe 10 days, maybe like less 10 days or something, but like something like that. So and for funding.Basically, like, yeah, he belongs to like one production company, and then that production company invested the almost half of the money, but also like he got the half of the budget like from the crowdfunding.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. And in terms of this year festival, Rotterdam Festival, the fact that it is kind of online festival, I want to know how was his experience thus far from an online.Festival.
まあ、もちろんそのロッテルダム映画祭は本当にずっと行きたかった映画祭なので、現地行きたかったなって思いも未だにもちろんあるんですけど、ただその、まあ、今回そのロッテルダム非常にそのゲストに対して手厚いというか、教育するのもすごく強くあるなと思っているので、そこら辺をオンラインでしっかり普通に多分映画祭でやってることを同じようにオンラインでもやれてるのかなと思いますから。それはなんか非常にこう貴重な体験をさせてもらってるなというふうに思います。で、まあ、実際その何回か一緒にね、そういうミーティングもさせてもらって非常に勉強になりますし、映画を見るというだけでなくて、そういうこうなんか交流の場として、オンラインでもしっかりできるんだなっていうのは思ってます。ただまあ、やっぱり昨日上映があったと思うんですけど、そこでやっぱり、自分の映画をやったのは初めてだったと思うので、思うというか初めてだったので、そこはお客さんと一緒にこう、どういうものがリアルに肌感としてあるのかっていうのは単純に経験したもっとしたいなというふうには単純に思いますから、ね、やっぱり。
はい。So of course the Rotterdam is like always like, you know, I mean, he wants to attend the festival, so the he wanted to visit the Rotterdam and like, you know, I mean, attend the real physical the festival.But the Rotterdam Festival is very like a unique because the festival has the education program for the filmmakers who selected the for the festival, and those kind of like that kind of festival is very unique, he thinks, and so that's why that he thinks that he has like a very good experience, like, you know, I mean, the, even like, you know, I mean, the online festival, like the meeting with the other filmmakers or like the like some experts and those kind of the meetings, like, you know, I mean, he attended and like very useful for him. But of course, last night screening, the world premiere was it's totally the world premiere and not like, you know, I mean, the even screened the in Japan. So he never looked at the real reaction from the audience. So he wanted to like, of course, attend the like physical screening and like, you know, I mean, the feels the audience reaction.
Okay, good. Thanks. I think I have asked almost all the questions that I want. I wonder if the director has anything to say or want to add anything to the interview.
はい。そうですね。じゃあセクシャルドライブのことでもいいですかね、少しね。はい。セクシャルドライブはその、ちょっとこう今回のインタビューで言いましたけど、直接的ではない表現でいかにこうエロティックなものを描けるかってことを自分なりにこう実験的にやった映画で、でもちょっと小難しいこともありながら、それを一回抜きにして、ブラックコメディとして、とにかくお客さんに笑ってほしいというか、っていうことがすごく大きいモチベーションでもあるので、見てる人が、まず気軽に見てもらって、笑って、エロいって感じてもらえるものだと、だといいなというふうに思ってます。
So the sexual drive is like the film, like he wants to express the eroticism like without any explicit sex scenes. So it's kind of like the experimental way he thinks, but like even like the those concept or something, but like basically this is like black comedy. So he wants the audience to laugh at the like the scenes and like and also like he just wants the feel the like eroticism like errors from the film. So that's it.